Hello, how are you? I'm Dr. Manju Gupta, Associate Professor in the Department of Education, Meerut College, Meerut. And this college has been associated with Chaudhary Charan Singh University. And today I'm just going to teach something about curriculum development. So here we go. What curriculum means? All the acts and activities which revolve around the course and content of the syllabi of the class. So curriculum here refers to everything that transpires in the course of planning, teaching and learning in an educational institution. The curriculum development refers to the planning of educational programs, which includes the identification and selection of the educational objectives, the selection of learning experiences, the organization of learning experiences, and the evaluation of the educational program. Friends, there are certain approaches to curriculum development. Approaches to curriculum development are likely to vary with different kinds of educational institutions. That is, the curriculum used in professional colleges are not similar with those used in academic colleges and might not be feasible in elementary schools. The TEM approach here refers to various aspects of developmental process, including the assumptions, the purposes, the criteria, procedures, and the stakeholders and the participants in the curriculum development program. There are certain approaches, but I have taken only the psychological basis for curriculum development program. So there are three approaches mainly. One is the cognitive approach, behavioristic approach, and the constructive approach. Behavioristic approach is the most traditional, the oldest, but most preferred approach to curriculum development. It may be called as technical or scientific approach. It clarifies the objectives, why to teach, content, what to teach, methods, how to teach, sequence, when to teach, and scope, how much of a curriculum should be taught to the learners. It is based on a blueprint where instructional objectives are specified, content, teaching methods, strategies, teaching aids are selected and arranged in a psychological manner. Students' achievement in terms of their change in behavior are measured and evaluated in terms of instructional objectives. It provides feedback to the construct or reconstruct the curriculum as per need of the learners, as per need of the society, as per need of the nation. Now I come to cognitive approach. Cognitive approach refers to productive curriculum or cooperative curriculum approach. This will help in achieving the objectives of higher education optimally. As such, change in curriculum does not mean change in courses or content, or in teaching methods, or in evaluation techniques. Such changes will not increase necessarily the productivity. Enhancing productivity needs more changes in the curriculum, which will need the futuristic vision. The curriculum must be more productive, more time saving, but also giving the student the main concept related to their major conceptual fields, which link their knowledge to other fields of knowledge. Here I refer to cooperative teaching. Interdisciplinary teaching should be adopted when we are planning for cognitive approach for curriculum development. With such a vision, curriculum will gain not only flexibility, but it will broaden the horizon of the students, enabling them to work in a changing world. Now I come to constructive approach. Constructive approach to curriculum is based on the concept that knowledge cannot be imposed but created by the learners as they attempt to make sense of their experiences. It is child-centered curriculum where role of the teacher shifts from teaching or instructions to facilitator or a guide. The curriculum is planned keeping in view the context, students' learning goals, meaningful activities, and application, active involvement of the learners. Teacher encourages students' dialogues, inquiry, and elaborations. It promotes collaborative teaching, integrative teaching, inquiry-based teaching. So friends, these were the three approaches for curriculum development. Now come to the nature of curriculum development. Curriculum development is a practical enterprise and not a theoretical study. The system must be designed to operate effectively in a society where a number of constraints are present with human beings who all have purposes, preferences, and dynamic mechanism in operation. Hence, it is very important in curriculum development to examine and analyze significant conditions that influence the construction and operation of the curriculum. Now we come to the procedure in curriculum development. It has certain steps. The first one is preliminary analysis. Preliminary analysis is very necessary to take the decision whether to construct or reconstruct the curriculum. It is based on the current need and demand of the individuals, demand of the society and the nation at large. Societal changes, technological advancement in every sphere of our lives, opportunities for employability, political scenario and policies, globalization, etc. are certain factors which are responsible for change in curriculum. Lack of vocational courses, unemployment, lack of job opportunities, rigid courses, rigid method of teaching are some of the factors prevailing in the society due to obsolete courses and traditional mode of teaching learning process. The entire overhauling is required to make education more functional and relevant in present day scenario. Rationale for curriculum development. Why to construct or reconstruct the curriculum? Let it go. No. After identifying the need to which the curriculum development should be responsive and the constraints under which the curriculum must operate, the curriculum developers have a very clear futuristic vision to work on the several components of the total program of the curriculum development. The third one is major task in curriculum development. There are four major tasks. The first one is selecting and defining the objectives, selecting and creating learning experiences, organizing learning experiences, and curriculum evaluation. Selection of the objectives. Curriculum development is not only a process based on the precise rules but also articulates values, culture, ethics, critical judgment, and empirical testing. In selecting the objectives, curriculum developers need present data and future estimates, on the basis of which they predict the opportunities and hypothesize problems arising from various sectors of society such as the occupational, socio-cultural, socio-economic, home, family, and recreational status, which decides what type of the curriculum should be developed for. Then comes defining of objectives. So objectives for curriculum development are defined in terms of generalized behavior of the students involved and other stakeholders. The criteria for selecting the objectives is particularly from distinguishing the more important from the less important ones. The selection and definition of the objectives of curriculum are very, very important for curriculum development. It is a continuous and a complex task to be performed sincerely and earnestly. Now we come to the second step, that is selecting and creating learning experiences for curriculum development. Creating and learning experiences is an even more artistic phenomena than the selection of objectives. It depends on the creativity, ability, attitude of the curriculum developers. More dependability is on teachers and the availability of the resources. The support system from the administration and management is also necessary for selecting and creating learning experiences. Now we come to the third step, that is the organizing learning experiences. This is again the functional part of the curriculum. How to organize all those gathered learning experiences in the curriculum to maximize the realization of the objectives. It requires the combined efforts of one and all. Now we come to curriculum evaluation. It, in the process of collecting the data on the curriculum development and its implementation and to determine its worth with the aims and objectives, it is decided whether to adopt, reject or revise the curriculum. Most of the planning, monitoring and reporting of the curriculum activities is guided by the objectives and conceptions of the stakeholders. Curriculum is evaluated at each step from formulation of objectives to effective implementation. The efficiency of the curriculum is evaluated in terms of achievement, satisfaction, employability, relevance, appropriateness for the stakeholders, to be more specific for the learners. The curriculum evaluation is of three types: formative, summative and diagnostic. Formative evaluation is supposed to be pre-evaluation of the curriculum in which the planners do it before or during the curriculum implementation with the aim of improving the design and performance. It is futuristic in nature. It has been done by judgmental data, which has been gathered by rating scales, questionnaires or interviews, or by observational data, which has been gathered from face-to-face interaction, observations and interviews, or by students' achievement, which is the main evidence to make reformation in the curriculum. The other one is summative evaluation. Summative evaluation is also called the post-evaluation, which takes place during the curriculum implementation. But most often it is undertaken at the end of the project. Observation techniques and students' achievement are taken as evidence for adopting, rejecting or reforming the curriculum. The fourth one is the diagnostic evaluation. If any part of the curriculum is not functioning appropriately, maybe due to social, cultural, ethical elements, or maybe due to language or activities, or maybe due to content, or maybe due to other acts and activities, those things can be removed or added with some changes. To study the efficacy of these changes, that is additions or subtractions in the curriculum, diagnostic evaluation is done after the implementation in natural curriculum development process. To conclude, I want to say curriculum evaluation provides basis for curriculum policy decisions, for feedback to make changes in curriculum, and helping to determine the degree to what extent the existing curriculum is effective. Specific strengths and weaknesses are identified for its reformation and implementation. Thank you so much.